travel line through here.
Good afternoon, Gills fans. Welcome back to another episode of Gills in the Blood TV. It is match day live time. We are nearly at the Priestfield Stadium for Gillingham versus Newport County. We have Boz and Ava with us at the moment. Team news has just come in. No changes, mate?
No.
Somewhat unsurprising, I'd say. Yeah. Yeah, no need to change it after what was a really good performance Tuesday night to win at the county ground against our dear friends. A side that had, I think, scored in every home game and not lost at home, I think, this season. So, yeah, really good performance after the disappointment of last Saturday. That team in four is Jake Turner in goal, a back four of Alexander, Masterson, Ogie, Malone. It's then Dom Jeffries and Ethan Coleman sitting. Johnny Williams in the 10, Macca as the 9, and Jaden Clark and Connor Mahoney from the sides. And there is a return for Timmy Dieng to the bench after nearly 2 months out injured. Boz, win today would give us 3 wins from 5 under Keith Millen. Have us and perhaps others been a little bit harsh on Millen so far?
Possibly. However, do I want him to get the job full time? No.
No, I don't want him to get the job full time, and I don't think he actually wants the job full time. But I think 9 points from 15 would be a decent return, considering it has been a fairly tough month. Yeah, it'd be, I think, 9 from 18 in the month entirely, because Neil Harris was still in charge for Crewe. Yeah, but yeah, it wouldn't be a bad return at all. But we are nearly at the ground, so we will bring you more footage when we get inside. Score predictions for today and thoughts on the team being unchanged from Tuesday. No surprises?
Not for me, no. I suppose it's a game. I don't think it's
absolutely.
Yeah, I prefer 2 up top, but you can't knock, not taking the side after a good result. Yeah, very good result against the side with a terrific home record. So, more than happy today for the side now.
And Matt, in terms of the bench as well, we've strengthened depth now with Timmy Dieng returning.
I'm so glad to see him back on the pitch. I definitely feel we've missed my presence with him in the middle of the park. And a great win the other week, as any other day, so glad that we're going with an unchanged team. And I just feel this Newport team are here for the taking today. So look, I'm going to go, I reckon, 3-0.
Yeah, well, surprisingly, I'm agreeing. I think looking at their away records, come out the blocks really quick, on the front foot, score early. I'd be very surprised if this is not a very, very comfortable home win. I remember standing there here last season, Matt, last home game, saying we're going to win easily. We got to win 2-1, so that's a chance for you. But no, I'm really confident today. 3-0 at least.
Enjoy the game, fellas.
same terms, and look here, daisy cutter. Stay with it. Scott Malone. Where's it going? Trying to get byline, still trying to get byline. That's going to be. Oh, it's not gone out. Dom Jeffries unlucky. Chance for the away team, but they should lead, to be fair. Jake Turner does really well to react to his own initial error because he spills the first one, then gets up really big. Bodol thinks he's got a tap in, doesn't he? But that's a warning. 14 on the clock, still goalless. Just penalty to Newport out of the blue. I think that's on Alexander, not on Turner. Alexander sold him well short. He's not having a great few days in 12-yard boxes, is he, unfortunately? 18-yard boxes, sorry. It's a stonewaller. Absolute stonewaller. Sold Turner massively short. And Turner might be injured as well. I know Turner's saying to the referee that he's caught him, but he never got there, did he, unfortunately? Yeah, exactly. Oh, yeah, it's an absolute nailed on head. It's going to be Bogle. It's going to be Bogle. Gills fans behind the goal doing their best to put him off. Just waiting for the referee to set himself. Telling people not to get in the box. Bogle head down, not looked up, has he? Referee's whistle comes now. Here it comes. Gone in. We trail. It's another penalty, Bos, and it's Alexander again. To me, this is the wrong call. First one spot on. This is completely wrong. They just showed it. The shoulder. The bloke has gone down like he's been shot, holding his face, which is embarrassing. Bottom line is that it could be 2-0 very quickly. He's going to go the same way. Doesn't change it. Come on, Jake. It's gone the other way. 2-0. Come on, Connor. Get that down. Come on, Connor. That's a good block. Need something soon, don't we? Because unfortunately we don't come from behind to win football matches. I know there's only half hour gone, but big arse. Nearly one back, was Conor Mahoney again. Does it all himself. What's he, 30 yards out? He's hit the top of the bar and gone out for a goal kick. Yeah, keeper's just watching it and opening. 36 played, still two down. Johnny Williams has just missed the sitter, hasn't he, Boz? Charlie's on the shot. Charge down, Mahoney clips an absolutely brilliant ball to the back post, and how has he missed the target? That's harder to put wide, to be fair. That's your chance.
Get into
Half-time, the Priestfield Stadium is currently Gillingham 0, Newport County 2. Goals coming from Omar Bogle twice from the spots. We've not been good enough. First penalty is Stonewall. Second one is not. Unfortunately, we will be talking about our fans after the game again. There is a picture going on social media at the moment after Omar Bogle scores.
After the penalty, that's where I sit. I can tell by the Newport player reactions that something had happened.
A few local non-league results is Ipswich 0, Dagenham Riverine 0.
And then we've seen the picture and the video on social media. It's clear as day. As clear as day. It's depressing. I can't concentrate on the football now, to be honest. We're 2-0 down. Yeah, obviously, I'm not happy.
Truro 0, Tottenham 1, Western Super League 0,
The only way I can see the FA dealing with us is a points deduction. It's as simple as
that. And a stadium closure, yeah.
You would be screaming. If this was Millwall, if this was club renowned for trouble, you would be calling for a stadium ban. And this is the thing, I can't sit here. It's every week.
We're bringing our kids to football. We've got people bringing their kids to football, and this is what we're having to talk about and put up.
You know, the last game, you had fakes being chucked at the keeper. We've had the racial stuff before. We've had the sexual discrimination stuff before.
One last one.
It is depressing.
It is really, really sad.
The minority is getting larger and larger.
And they're the ones that are making all the noise, aren't they? They're the ones that are leading to us being spoken about in a poor light again.
We can talk about the football, we can talk about the mistakes made by our right back and the referee and whatever, but my overriding feeling is just about what's happened off the pitch again. What's going to happen with this club going forward? We're in a bad state. I don't know how the club deal with it, because it's down to individual fans, but there couldn't be that many morons in Medway, surely, that come here every week.
Like to think, but unfortunately at the moment actions keep trying to sort of indicate the opposite, don't they? Let's try and get back to the football briefly. I mean, we've got to make changes and we've got to score the next goal, but is there any belief amongst the fan base and the players that they get back into it? I don't think so.
Two goals,
So first to go is going to be Nick. He's going to try and hit the crossbar, and if he does, he'll get hospitality for two. So here we go. He's all ready and raring to go.
Having a real go, yeah. Maybe it's not just on the pitch that we need to make changes. Early corner, Gills. I feel we have to get the next goal. We said that half time, and it has to be soon, doesn't it? Coleman! Ooh, took a nick off Masterson, I think, didn't it?
Come on, Connor.
Get up, Ethan. It was flapped again. It's no foul. It's no foul. It's not injured. No way is he injured. Another one into the crowd. End of the final 10 minutes, mate. It's just picked out, and like you just said, we've had a lot of ball. Keeper's not had to make a save. He's not even fully fit, we don't think, and we've not tested him at all. We've done the same thing. There we go, we've done it again. We go centre back to left back, and then they get in their shape, and we give it to their centre halves or their centre midfielders. Not even sure what the shape is. Like, stay with us though, Dom Jeffries. That's a better ball. Connor Mahoney. Go on, Connor. Go on, Dom. Mahoney. Oh, my word. It's just nearer us than that is the back of the net.